Welcome. Today is Wednesday, the 3rd of August. This is The Best of the Best, a feature presentation in collaboration with the WBIF, the stream team. Live in the studio, we have my good self, Eric McAlpine from the UK, from Bulgaria, our organizational supremo, Bozidar Iliev, aka Bojo, from Italy, our technical guru, Gian Lazzaro Sana. Hi, guys.
Hi, Eric. Hello, everyone. Hello, dear guests in the studio.
Hi, Eric, and hi, everyone. Welcome to the second semi-final.
And our special guest from Romania, Mr. Florin Papa. Hi, Florin.
Hello, everyone.
This event is at the semi-final stage. The cat has got the cream, and the cream is rising to the top. The pedigree players and the creme de la creme on the WBIF ratings lists are shining brightly and expressing their talents. They are showing the world their PR excellence and supreme calculus. And at the business end of this outstanding event, who is going to state their claim to be the best of the best? Who's going to make the final? Battling it out over a succession of 5-point matches. Clock settings are 1 minute per game with a 10 seconds delay. A special mention to our honored special guest, Florin Popper from Romania, the inventor and creator of this prestigious contest. It's time. When gladiators collide, Grandmaster Dirk Schiemann from Germany versus Fernando Braconi from Italy. The machine against Il Visione, the vision. Dirk on BMAP has a PR average of 3.1. On the WBIF, he has a PR average of 2.6. Fernando on the WBIF has a PR average of 3.2. Without any further delay, I'd like to invite into the studio our special guest, Florin Popper. Welcome back, Florin.
Oh, thank you.
And what do you think about this semi-final coming up?
Well, I expect a great match. I'm very curious about Fernando Braconi because he's the first time in this tournament that he plays a contest where PR counts. So I expect, in fact, he performed very well in the first round, but now it's a tougher opponent. Dirk Schiemann, we know it's one of the best in this kind of format. So I expect a PR below the sum under six. So both players to play under three.
Oh, nice prediction indeed. And Bojo, what do you think about this semi-final coming up?
Okay, very, very interesting match, obviously, which can be said about all matches in the tournament. The defending champion, Mr. Dirk Schiemann, against the both live and online world champion with Team Italy, Fernando Braconi, who also managed to win the bronze medal at the past World Championship in Monte Carlo last week. So he was very close to win all the three titles, which is absolutely incredible. Well, Dirk played very, very strong in all the last year's matches. And this year in round one, he played an average of 2.58. While Fernando also played well, he played 3.03. So based on those numbers, probably we can consider Dirk slight favorite. But of course, they are very close, and it also depends on heroes. If Fernando gets three wins out of five matches, he will already have a very good chance to win and go to the final, where Hideaki Ueda is waiting for the winner of tonight's match.
Yes, wonderful prospect for the final, whichever of these fine players get through, of course. And Gian Lazzaro, what do you think about the semi-final coming up?
Very, very interesting match. I agree with Bojo that Dirk is a slight favorite, but less favorite than I think a lot of people think. Fernando is a wonderful player and can win. I would not be surprised if he beats Dirk.
I agree. Not knowing Fernando as well as yourself and Florin, he definitely can beat anyone on his day and is very, very consistent with his PRs at the high level. So I'm really looking forward to this clash as well. Who's going to get through for the right to play Hideaki Ueda in the final? Should be a marvelous clash. Really looking forward to it. All right. And I know that the World Championships have just finished. Bojo, have you got any insight or any thoughts on what happened in Monte Carlo?
Well, although I was traveling myself and I was not able to follow very closely the tournament, I still saw some matches. And I have to say big congratulations to Sander Leo from Denmark for making it all the way to the World Championship title. And it's been a great year for him because he also won the UBC Contenders Tournament in Istanbul. And funny enough, the World Championship final was between Sander and Zdenek Žižka, and they repeated the final from Istanbul. So definitely both of them, both Sander and Zdenek, are in top form, and Sander obviously in really, really good good condition, playing some extraordinary backgammon. And I hope he's going to give his best in the crown match against Mochi so that we all can experience some absolutely incredible piece of backgammon there.
Hear, hear. And Gian Lazzaro, what did you think about the World Championships?
I think that this year a lot of very, very strong players in the first places. Some other years we had some not favorite players on the top, but this time a lot of wonderful players. For example, Wilcox Snellings played very, very well, and he went out with Zdenek, but it was maybe quarterfinal. And really, really very, very good matches in the end. So it seems that also in Monte Carlo, best players are going to the best results. And I noticed a very, very good level in the streaming, very good commentaries, very good technical streaming. So my congratulations to the team that worked on it, because they made really a wonderful job.
Hear, hear, and very pleased to hear that, Gian Lazzaro, from your perspective. I think it's very important for the World Championships to have high-level streaming and good clarity, good commentary. This is the pinnacle of backgammon, is to be World Champions. So for me, that should be supported by, you know, really good streaming and having things at the higher level. So I'm pleased that this year they really had a good eye on attention to detail and put on a good show for the people that were there and the people that were viewing at home. So well done to everyone there, and let's crack on with next year. And over to Florin. Florin, what are your thoughts on the World Championships this year?
I agree with Gian Lazzaro. It was probably the first year that I have seen so many strong players in the last stage of the tournament. So all the last matches were played amazingly. I mean, Snelling's Lilo was like 230 bot. Also, when Fernando played 330, Ziska played almost the same level, except at the final because of the very strange back game. One game that was enough to destroy the LPR, but doesn't change much. And also in the other, there are also Grandmaster there. So the luck this time was with the players, with the strong players. And also I noticed the same as Božidar said, that the same that performed well in the UBC performed well even here. Lot of, and also players can be strong contenders for the next year. I hope they will go like Snellings, mentioned by Janaza, and Fernando Braconi also can be a strong contender next year. Let's hope they will go over there. For now, they cash some money.
Yes, I'm quite sure that Sanders got an extra couple of euros in his back pocket, and I'm sure he'll use that wisely. But big congratulations to him. Sander Lilof from Denmark, world champion 2022. And as Božidar mentioned earlier about the UBC final, I'm pretty sure, knowing the super high talent of Sander, that he'll be chomping at the bit to ruffle Super Grandmaster Mochi's feathers. So I think that will be really the one to watch. I'm quite sure it will be a spectacle and a super match to watch for the UBC. All right. Okay. Let me just have a quick look here. I can see that are the players ready? Just looking, checking.
Yes, the players are ready.
Okay, so let's fire over. Okay, they're on the table. Bojo, if you want to, you can give them the go ahead so we don't keep them waiting. Yep, there's the pleasantries. Really looking forward to this checker challenge in Cube Conflict. And on guard, we're off. Okay, nice shake.
So semi-final number two is already on the way.
Indeed. Double two, lovely shake as well. Yeah, tricky, isn't it, with the final two? Yeah, powers up, makes the rack. Very nice, yeah. Makes the five. Very nice. Okay. Yeah. Oh.
Beautiful 6-3.
Yeah. That's the kind of roll that you really enjoy when you're under pressure with the single straggler. Lovely shake there. And Dirk. Yes.
I can double. It's too early, I think.
Too early for the cube, are you saying there, Florin?
Yeah, it's behind in the race, but okay, escaping, I think she should have think the cube, my opinion, Dirk, a bit.
Yeah, still not quite there. I don't think he'll do anything fancy. Yeah.
I'll go for the safe play here as well.
Me too. Must pay respects to the powerful, well, now a 5-point board. Was
now
a
5.
Board. Yeah. Indeed.
Okay, 5-2. Does he make the ace or does he bring another checker in the attacking zone? It's better.
I think so. Otherwise, you get what you famously call the island position. Bit too much.
Okay, look at this 5-3.
Yeah.
Terrible. Bring both the spare checkers.
Yeah, no choice there. You can't give the shot against that 5-point board. Too much.
Getting worse and worse. Now he has to bring a point, probably the 5-point.
I think so. I think you can't give the shots from the mid. It's just too costly when you get hit So I think it's right to give up the five here, as Bojo has made the first suggestion. I like his idea.
15 shots, too many.
Yeah, it's just so hurtful when you get hit. And he has to do something now. He has to do something, so it gives you more chance to stay safe for longer.
So I'm pretty sure Dirk is happy now that he hasn't doubled earlier, as Florin was saying that he probably might do. But look at this.
Oh, wow.
This is a return shot.
It is, but you just got to stick two on the roof and close the eyes and cross the fingers. Yeah, just do this and hope he doesn't get the deuce. And what a shot under pressure with two on the roof. Oh, and look at this. We have action.
Now, probably, if no deuce, it will be a good time to consider the cube.
Definitely. Okay.
Okay, no deuce.
Yeah.
Well, probably this is still too early.
It is, yeah. Just okay, he's on the front foot. Yeah, okay, he's going for it. There's the fan.
Nice brave play by Dirk.
Fast also.
Yeah.
Any chance that it's too good now?
I think there isn't. I don't know. Close call. Genesaro?
Double six don't cover. Or...
no, I don't think it is too good. I think it is a double and a pass.
Yeah. I'm leaning a little bit more towards your feelings. 3-1, 5 or a 10 to cover.
Okay, so Dirk went for the too good.
Yeah, he did.
So bringing one more down looks better.
Yes. And? Yeah. Still. Okay. Fan. 65.
Okay. 10-4 and 14-9.
Yeah. Looks good.
Yes, he's waiting for another deuce to cube.
Yeah, I don't think he'll be cubing now. Yeah, he'll go for that undoubled gammon. Yeah.
Both players playing close to zero.
Bodes well. Oh, and there's a shot. And there's the hit. From Fernando, back in the ball game.
And now it's Fernando's turn to consider the double.
I think I should. I redouble here. I will redouble.
I like your
not
thought.
Redouble.
No, it's from the center.
Dirk didn't double.
Right. So yeah. It's a double for sure.
Yeah. I mean, it's 6, 10, 11, 4 off. Okay. No harm done.
Why he didn't double? What do you think?
Yeah, he's still got a lot of work to do to bring the checkers round. So I think he wants a few more activated numbers before he spins it.
Yeah, I think against 5 checkers, it would be a clear no double. But against 4 checkers, I'm not sure.
I think he should now. Now he's got 3 potential 6-point making numbers. I think, yeah.
There's the cube.
Yeah.
But let's see, we are after the game because now of miss cube. So Dirk had some miss cube.
Yeah.
But not much.
Just one small. Before the 5-3, this is exactly where we were discussing if it's too good or not.
Yeah.
So it's borderline. Double and too good.
Yeah. But tremendous start in this first game. Moving into the second now. both on hot form at the moment. Let's hope they can continue.
And it's tricky, this one.
It is tricky.
Probably this one. I like this one, what Dirk played.
Yeah.
Too dangerous to hit.
Yes, I agree. I agree. Just preserve your advanced position and try to get missed and keep your forward momentum.
And now a tricky 6-4 in return.
Yeah, but both these players really showing their class and deeper understanding of backgammon here. Not scared to take risks, put their checkers in the best position.
Now again.
Yeah. Yes.
Aces, deuces, fives and sixes hit back.
Yes.
One, two, almost, I don't know, so many numbers. Dangerous against with point board.
Yeah.
No anchor.
Paul McGrill would be proud seeing all these moves.
And the bad number for Fernando is six, but with six he can hit. So what is it? Only 3-4, 3-5, and 4-5 that doesn't hit.
Yeah, but if he does...
No, it's a blunder.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, he should have hit.
Yeah.
But I understand his doubt, because with so many return shots, it looked definitely dangerous.
It definitely does, and he's obviously paying the natural respects to the tremendous form of Fernando Braconi as well.
I guess that main reason for this to be a blunder is that he leaves a direct shot with all threes anyway.
Yes.
Plus, he is not gaining anything in the race.
Yeah. And oh, the girls! What a shake here from Fernando, checking out his options, working out what he's going to do here.
Well, it looks like 15, 8, and 9 to 4 to me.
Yeah, he played it, but he didn't confirm, so I don't know why he didn't like.
Maybe he's going this way to for some, if he gets missed, he's got more cube value here. Maybe that's what he's looking at. And with nothing on the other side, why not? Solves a problem early while he's underdeveloped. Ah, there's the QB. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that was very impressive play by Fernando, the double fives.
Yeah, yes. I agree, because for me, it was normal to play the other one. But he fought it well, the correct plan.
Very well.
Yes, living up to his nickname with aplomb. The vision.
He thought it's a double after if he's missed, but it's not by a small margin.
Yeah, I think it's fine. If it's your instincts and it's a little bit off, I think it's better to be that side of it than on the other side, missing big. So, yeah. No problem for me.
Okay, Dirk is ready for the contact.
He is. Board is ready. Will he get the shot? If he does, it's going to be a single shot once, I feel.
Okay, keeping 1-6, probably not the best idea, because double sixes is going to turn from a super joker into anti-joker.
Indeed. Okay, Dirk catching up in the race here. The lovely quads. Okay, we're going to see some action. Oh, lovely shake. Okay, bye-bye, boardy. Yeah. Okay, he's in.
Okay, big favorite now, Fernando.
Indeed. Okay, peels. Oh!
Still a big favorite.
Yes, he is, but what a Christmas cracker there for Dirk.
Now 2-1, not the best.
Yeah. Okay, still in it. Oh!
This is going to be enough, I think.
Yeah, it's looking very probable. It's going to be 3-0 to Fernando here. And there it is. Game to Fernando. Starting very well.
Starting attacking. Because of the score, 5 away, 2 away, bringing 2 down.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, this was cube saving.
Massively cube saving, just at the right time. Okay, 41. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
24 to 22, definitely, yeah.
Yeah, in and out, shake it all about. 51, yeah.
Okay, the board is already strong. 42 is usually making a point, but not this time.
Yes.
And probably the cube is coming right now.
It's going to be, yeah, it's going to be coming very soon. But I do like the tempo of play of both the players. They found their groove very early, flowing nicely, taking their time when it's needed.
Oh, make the 5 point.
Yes, in a heartbeat.
Also, because it doesn't hit the last one. So
even if he has the 5 point, it's crucial here.
I agree with Bojo. You want to give yourself a fighting chance for the rest of the battle of this game. 5 points.
Okay, 65. Bye-bye, 8 point.
Yep. And, oh, what a shot. Yeah, it's this or hit twice.
13 to 8. I don't think hit twice is an option here.
I would have come out here.
I would have been tempted, I tell you, just because of the chance to win the undoubled gammon with the extra one lying around. I'd have had a little look at it.
Actually, it was better, but almost the same.
Yeah, it's just a case of how you see the game developing, really. I would have maybe considered it.
Second dance.
Yeah.
And now Dirk needs to enter and to roll a 6. Okay, this works as well.
It works very well.
Double even four. Better.
Yeah.
Probably even better, yeah.
Yeah, I think I would have...
Yeah, going to 18 was very important here.
Yeah, it was. You're snookered a little bit over there with the configuration.
It's not a blunder, yeah, but small blunder, but still a blunder.
Yeah, just too much pressure on your back checkers with 4 there in quadrant 1. Very important. You don't self-snooker. And now he has a decision. Yeah.
That would be my play, because to avoid getting pointed inside his home board. And he definitely has to remove the one from 7, I think.
He probably wants to keep it, maybe, because otherwise it's difficult to win.
Yeah, no, I like the decision. I think he needs to have more checkers in the outfield to try and contain the single straggler that wants to run around. So I like that move, coming to 18.
And he avoided being pointed on, which was the most important for me.
Yes.
And the question is now, does he switch to the ace?
Yeah. Ooh, I think he has to. Yeah, just to take some pressure off. Yeah, just too many chances if he doesn't. He'd love to roll a 3. Yeah.
Okay. Fan. Gnut didn't like this one as well.
Okay.
Oh, well. Difficult game for Dirk.
Yeah, tough plays, but this is what it takes to be the best of the best. Okay.
Too many dudes to go out.
Yeah, two directs this way, three directs if he pops it, but where's the five? It's
even this five actually is not so good.
Yeah, I think I just come out and bite the rusty bullet. Keep my checkers.
2-3, 2-5, 3-5, 5-5, that's it. Seven numbers.
Yeah, but it's behind the anchor.
And 5-5 was one of them.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just a little bit anti-positional, isn't it? Putting it behind the anchor, the dilly builder.
But now it's still a very bad role for Dirk. He can't play with the back checkers, and then what can he do?
He's thinking about whether to dump or not, isn't he? Okay, it's either this or pure and just leaving the four and bring two in.
I will bring two in because it's too ugly to bury a checker too early.
I think I like this one because he needs to stop the sixes.
Yeah, this is the best for making it difficult for the straggler to get away.
Okay, another decision, pick and pass or running?
Yeah. He really needs something here. Didn't get it. He's hoping for a three or a six.
Fernando immediately entered.
Yes. Okay.
Dirk needs something big or three and something. This is good for him.
Super shot. Anything doesn't hit.
Fernando cannot jump over the three points.
It's too strong, this three prime. Way too strong.
Three prime is absolutely untouchable.
Yeah. And?
Yeah, too risky this for the gammon in the match.
Yeah, you're just too exposed. Fives, fours, twos, tens, elevens to hit. You've just got to do this and rely on the anchor to...
On the 3 point board, on the 3 prime.
Yes.
You work this time.
Yeah.
Okay, so double threes for Dirk hit anyway. And first mistake for Fernando.
Yeah, even if it blocks the 5-4, so only three numbers, but still not good to leave a shot.
Yeah. Okay.
Dirk still very well in the race, but finally he got something big, but very dangerous now.
Yeah.
No way this is a double.
Nah, you can easily fluff here and give too much to the opponent.
Okay, 6-1.
You'll be hitting.
He has to hit loose, right?
Yeah, that's an option.
Yeah, all kind of plays itself, in my opinion. You've got to hit, you can't let him run away.
Okay, Dirk is in, couldn't hit.
Yeah.
Now again.
Again.
Yeah, he's got to, just to... if he doesn't...
This time is more dangerous.
A lot more dangerous, yeah. And
this time, Dirk manages to hit. So now...
And then...
Now double fives.
Oh, wow. Big hit. Big roll.
Now another chance for Dirk to hit back.
Yes. And fan.
And now he can cube, I think, no?
Yep, I think you do cash. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, look at the PRs. We have mid-cube for Fernando. And both of them are playing 2.15.
Ah, great stuff here. Really pleased to see that. Both players on fire. Playing well, making good decisions.
Really okay, good. So the missed cube is exactly before the 6-1 when I was thinking that there is no way this to be a cube.
Yeah.
So I have blundered here as well.
Don't worry, I have blundered as well. I'm not sure about Gian Lazzaro and Florin. But yes, I would have been in the same boat as you there, Bojo.
I don't think I would have doubled.
No, me neither.
Yes, well done. We love the honesty. Yeah. Okay. So, Fernando, irresistible at the moment. Can he see it through and win this first set? Okay.
These guys rolling double threes this game.
Yeah.
Three out of nine times. And double fives, two out of 11 times. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sure that Dirk will be happy with this, being 0-4 Crawford. Stepping it up. Trying to win this game. Stay in the first set. Okay. And, okay, bit of unstacking. Yeah. Okay.
62.
Yes.
So now he needs to avoid aces and fours.
Yeah.
Does that mean he's gonna roll 4-1?
4-1's actually not too bad.
Not too bad, no.
Yeah, oh, that's a great shake. Oh!
That's also a great shake.
It is. Yeah, sees no future with the lovely stack of 10 checkers on 6 and 5. So he's on his way.
So 2-1, not the best for Fernando.
Yeah.
63 working well for Dirk both times.
Indeed. Okay. So, big favorite in this game here, Mr. Schiemann. Looking like he's going to get back into the set. And? Yeah. Yeah, all standard. Yeah. And?
Long double.
Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah.
Okay, trying to get back.
Make it exciting.
Okay, it's not exciting anymore.
Yeah.
Before 1 post Crawford.
It's exciting for the match because 4-1.
Yes. Well, let's see if there is a free drop. I don't think so.
Yeah, agreed.
And it's game and go all the way for Dirk now.
It is. So makes it very exciting. One is going to be on the front foot going for the G. The other one is going to be playing consolidation moves and trying to not be too exposed. So, yeah.
3 point here.
Yeah.
Looks like the good game and go strategy.
Yeah, maximum contact.
Beautiful three. I don't think so. Really?
I didn't get enough time. I didn't get enough time to see. By the looks of it, well played, Fernando.
Wow, amazing.
Yeah, he just such great natural instincts for finding the best move at the most difficult of times.
I really, he played it very quickly. I'm surprised because he didn't spend time. Okay, he doesn't have much, only 1 minute.
Yeah, maybe. That
11-4 looked so beautiful.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. Oh, wow, look at this. What a shake. What a shake. Okay.
I don't know. He needs to.
Yeah, I wouldn't have done that myself.
Who is playing game and go here?
Yeah, I would have made a positional play, either 2 down from the mid or 1 down and unstacked the 6.
Anyway, Fernando in a really good position.
super position. Hoping he fans. Yes, now you can break the mid. Yes, you can break. Yes.
Easily, yeah.
Yeah, 5-4. Okay.
Even if getting hit with the super joker 2-1, he has all the aces.
Yeah.
Dirk also needs to enter for to get also more decision because he's going to lose the PR battle here. Okay, not by much, but
good spot, Florin. Yeah, makes a difference.
Okay, do we play 4 to the 3 point? Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be my play.
That's definitely my play.
Don't need the game also.
Oh, just the best way to win the game. I would clear from the back personally.
With the other, it doesn't leave any shots, so.
Yeah, the thing is that by bearing off 2, he keeps the 5 inner board points, which makes entering more difficult, but 4 to the 3 point looks much better to me.
I think so, but he could have run into problem with 3 in the future if he didn't make the play of putting 4 there. So I like this move.
And after rolling 6-4, he would have left a shot.
Yeah.
He still did, but Dirk cannot take advantage out of it.
Yeah. Okay, he's looking very good for Fernando here. In prime position to win this first set. Very difficult for Dirk here to win this set. Okay, and there's the miss.
Another miss.
And he'll stay hoping for a, oh my goodness.
Not another miss.
Yes. Yes.
Can't you roll it again? No, he can't. So first match goes to Fernando.
But the PR is very close. Actually, Fernando didn't have any more decision in the last because he rolled big numbers and Dirk overtake him.
Yeah, so Florin, what did you think about that first set?
Oh, but okay, was more luck for by Fernando, but let's see what how the PR. It's more interesting now to see the PR battle because okay, one match we always have someone who win, but if another managed to stay to not lose any point, would be very good. 1 point ahead.
Yeah, all to come. I'm sure it's being rinsed through the machines as we while we're waiting for that to come through. So overall, what did you think, Florin, in terms of the ebb and flow of the first set? What did you think about how they played in this first set?
They play very well. I mean, only a few small blunders, let's say 0-80, something like this. So there was not big mistake by any of the players. And some miscue. So when they played under 3, as expected, it played even under 2. So very well played by both.
Yeah, I concur. And Jan Lazaro, what did you think about the first set?
Yes, some difficult decisions, but they played very, very well. They made good choices, and I expected something like this. They are very, very good players.
Yeah, I want to add something. I think Dirk had the more difficult decision than Fernando in this. I mean, look, if I remember, it was more tricky by Dirk's side.
Yes, I agree with you, Florin. Definitely a few more trickier decisions for Dirk compared to Fernando in that one. I'm sure we're going to have more excitement in set 2. Just obviously making sure to rinse the match through XG to iron out any anomalies in regards to GNU on the Heroes platform here. So sure it won't be too long before we get an update in regards to that from Bojo. Yes, Bojo, what did you think about the first set?
Very important first game where Dirk was playing for Gammon, and then he gave Fernando a shot. Fernando managed to hit, and he won the game. Instead of losing 2 points, he won 1 point. So this was the key game for me. After that, Fernando had the advantage clearly. Dirk only won the Crawford game, but that was not enough. So interesting game. They are playing very well, very sharp at the moment. So I hope that it will remain all the way like this tonight. So yeah, looking forward to see the next matches.
Yes, myself also, very high level in the first set, both players on their best form. So just how we like it, all getting ready for set number two. And Florin, what have you been up to backgammon wise? Have you been playing or have you been traveling at all with your backgammon?
I played only the Bélier.
Okay, and how was?
Ah, didn't was so good, but I like the place there.
And did you have a nice time? How was the tournament run? Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah, for sure. It was well organized as always by Arda. It was first time for me to Bélier, so I prefer now to go to tournaments where I haven't been before.
Ah, so new explorations for you, huh?
New strategy, yeah.
Yeah, very nice. And do you play online yourself a little bit, or are you more, do you prefer to play live? Or
no, it used to play online and doing well in the World Championship. So focus on that one. Still many rounds to go, but I have 10 with 3. I have good chances now to get the prize.
Oh, would you give us more insight into what that is that you're playing and where?
In the online World Championship. Yes.
Ah, okay. Is that
It started in February or whatever, but it's many rounds, 13 rounds have been played. So probably another 6, something like this should be.
Ah, okay. And what's the match length, if you don't mind my asking?
It's 13 points.
Ah, okay. Oh.
But it's quite slow because a long time, I mean, between rounds, there are at least 10 days or something, or 2 weeks. So, but it's good to play in the summer, some online strong matches from home.
Yeah, and it sounds like it gives maximum time for you to be able to get through all the rounds and not be too congested. So I think that's a nice thing to have a little bit more leeway time-wise to schedule your matches and really try and get to your peak performance to do absolute damage. I think it's a good thing. And do we know anyone else that's in the later stages, like yourself? Any more recognized names of the backgammon world in the later stages with you, Florin?
Oh, there are, for sure. But I don't remember exactly now because there are still 60 players in. I just saw before Mislav won his match, so he's still in. He has 4 defeats, but he managed to win. So There are many, many, many good players, but not that with 3 PR. that with 3 PR, that play 3 PR are not in the first places. They are in with 4 defeats. With 2 defeats and 3 defeats, they are many strong players, but like player like 4 PR, let's say.
Yeah, I think that's the normal scheme of things. Well, of course, many of the backgammon community would feel that it's always the ones that play 1.x and 2.x get through and win the events. But as we know, this is backgammon. That is not what happens. It's definitely varied. Obviously, you have more winning chance over a long period of time with the lower PR. But yeah, that's what makes backgammon unique. Open to all, and as long as you play a pretty good level to high, you've got a chance to win the backgammon tournaments. Okay, Bojo, how are we going? Do we have any updates in regards to the first set?
Yeah, sorry for the delay, but because the results are very close, we are just reconfirming that we give up.
Yeah, I got 258 for Fernando and 2 for Dirk.
All right, so we can jump into the match number 2. The score is 1.28 for Fernando versus 0.72 for Dirk.
Wow, okay. Super stuff for the first set. Both players on fire. Really wanting to win this semi-final to get through to play Hideaki Ueda from Japan, lying in wait, showing they both mean business today and they're up for the action. So, yes, bodes well for the future sets here. Both in cracking form and playing well. Let's have a quick check to see. Have they... No, they're not quite there yet in setting up the table, but coming very, very soon, I'm sure. Not setting up a table yet. Yeah. So did you get a chance to watch any of the matches from the World Championships, Lauren?
Yeah. I follow almost all the last stage. At the beginning, not much, but in the last matches, yes, also because Fernando's from Italy, where I live, so I supported him. I commented with Gian Lazzaro the final in Italian, and I follow other commentators in Italian. So you have good time in Italy for this World Championship.
Yes, Italy on fire in the backgammon world, so it bodes well for growing the game naturally. Oh, and there's the little signal. I can see that they've set the table up, so... Let's get over there and fire away. Set number 2, coming right up. Okay, and Bojo, do we have the points tally as yet for what it is after the first set?
I'm sorry, Eric, would you like to repeat your question?
Yes, do we have the point score at the moment after the first set?
Yes, Fernando is leading by 1.28 against 0.72 for Dirk. The PRs, they were 2 for Dirk against 2.44 for Fernando.
Okay, fabulous. All right, set number 2. Fernando with the edge. Dirk wanting to come back. Here we go. Okay. All standard at the moment. Yeah. Ah, a little bit of duplicatus. Duplicating the 3 or considering it. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay, all right. So looks like an all the way. Yeah. What a shake there. Wow, double 3s. Wow, what a shake. Yeah. Okay. Standard, I feel. No need to get fancy. Still having a good think. All right. Let's see what they do. Okay. Double fours, very reasonable shake. Toughens up the board. Ready for action here. Just having a bit more of a think, Fernando. Whether to leave the shot or not is the question. So,
I wouldn't, because already three checkers back.
I agree with you.
Get hit with the four. It's...
Yeah. And maybe if he fans, it kills his cube a bit more so, being too powerful. Interesting. And step into the lion's mouth, into the jaws of the lion. He unstacks.
It was right to leave a shot there.
Ah, make them more powerful. Okay. Okay. And there's the cube. There is the cube. Yeah. Oh, wow. What a shake. What a shake. Okay. And is he going to give him a six or a ace?
Hey, minimize shots here. Eh?
I agree. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, it seems this game is difficult for both players. They already made a couple of mistakes.
Yes. Still going to have plenty of time, I'm sure, to correct that. But
The switch was necessary in case of Fernando.
Yes.
Didn't look like natural, but okay, the computer knows.
Yeah, computer's pretty good in these situations.
Dirk desperately needs an ace if he wants to avoid losing a double gammon.
Yes, good point. But okay. Forget an ace. I'm going to roll double ace. Super shape there from Dirk. Really giving him a chance to be competitive in this game.
A tricky this double three.
Yeah, and I think you got to break the 11. Break the 11 or make the four, one of the two. Yeah.
11 keeps some control. I will not.
Yeah, but they're not active on the. You'd love to make the 4 point next. So the problem with keeping 11 is that it's not really bearing in where you want it to be. So I think it was this or make the 4 point with two decisions, in my opinion.
It seems that Gnu likes this one.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so looking for rolling a six here.
Oh, beautiful. 3-1.
Super shake. Oh, and that's a really good shake for Fernando. Holds his position. Oh,
there is the six.
Now he became favorite. Dirk is favorite now.
Yeah, the sands of time.
Is this a cube? Is this a redouble? I think it is.
Because it's so strips Fernando. I would double him.
I would redouble here because otherwise it's very easy to lose the market.
Yeah, good point. And there's the board. The board's gone.
Yeah. Is he going to do it now?
I think it must do, yeah.
Yeah, but now it's a pass.
Yeah.
Okay, very well done, Dirk.
Indeed.
He did cube at the right time.
He did. Well played. Okay. There's the golden point.
Well, now we have close PR, the same PR as again, even now with the number is quite high.
And even PR, yes.
Yeah. Okay. Nothing better to do.
So 23 to 22 looks like a must, and then only 6-1 is the only option.
Yeah.
Ugly, but what can you do?
Yeah, I think it's a bit too early to consider giving up the midpoint. I agree with you, Bojo. Okay. Yeah. So scarpering before he's developed a little bit more. There's the hitter. Bam!
And we are already, I mean, considering the score, probably not, but at 0-0, it should have already been the cube.
Yeah, and I think this should be a 5 prime. Yeah.
Looks very strong, 5 prime.
It looks very powerful. I think the 5 prime is...
The 5 prime is better, yeah.
I feel very much so.
Even if getting hit by 1-6-2-6, there are the return shots at 22.
Now cube or not? Oh, what is... You not play this.
No, I think it was probably a misclick there.
Yeah. Or just playing for the fans.
Yeah, could be that as well. Yeah.
Always or like maybe that. The vision.
Yeah.
I will break here the 13. Oh, this one it's
very
yes. I would be very surprised if he goes for a 7-4 hit.
Yeah, I agree. There is the cube.
Because not many like chances here.
I think it has to be dropped now. It's just...
I think so.
Big drop.
I think so. It's just too difficult to put Humpty back together again. Too difficult. Too many threats. Escaping. 6-point prime. Blitz. Oh, everything. Everything in his favor. Okay. Lovely shake from Fernando here.
2 away, 5 away, this time in Dirk's favor.
Yes. Dirk on the front foot.
Gammon goal.
Yes.
And there is the Gammon goal chance.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
These two are easy.
Yes, that's right.
I don't know, making the 22.
I think I would have made 22 myself.
Me but too.
I think Fernando likes the contact a little bit more so with the stronger position. So understandable.
Okay, 2 consecutive errors for Fernando, and suddenly Dirk leads by over 1 point the PR.
Yeah, but not so many decisions, so the PR can...
Yes, of course.
Down. Easy.
Yeah, makes the 5. Fan.
A dance, yeah. And now pick and pass.
Yeah. Or
making the 4 point.
I think pick and pass. Trying.
Yeah, close decisions.
Yeah. Okay, what's he got? 64. Yeah.
Oh. Doesn't like the 7.
This I don't understand. I would make the bar.
I think it has to be. You don't want to be... no need to blitz just yet.
Too risky to blitz. Can lose game on here.
Yeah, I think so.
Not a big surprise. Dirk got the correct move.
Oh, well played, sir.
Yeah, it was not rewarded by the by the software.
Yeah, just showing you. Yeah, showing the deeper understanding. Super play, recognizing what you needed to do.
Yes, yeah, super play by Dirk.
Yeah. Fabulous stuff.
And he has the anchor, so this is very good for him, not losing a G.
Yes.
Now he will probably... Okay, I'm not sure anymore if he's going to attack again to the ace.
Good point. Yeah. And?
And now again.
He may attack.
Is it a double hit?
Good question, isn't it? It's either that or come into the six. One of the two.
This time the double hit looks...
Doesn't look as
me, which probably means it is not correct.
Yeah.
I stay with my idea. This is not hit, but can be, I can be wrong.
Okay.
Fan.
This time I got it correct.
Okay.
And now so six
make. Yeah, make and down. Yeah, looks right.
62.
Oh, this is great.
Oh, what a shot that is.
How about this one?
Now hit to go for the game on. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, 24, one of the worst numbers.
Yes, it is.
He has to move 8-4. There is nothing else to play. And now four blots all over the place.
Yeah. Yeah, exciting.
There you go. Double hit.
Wow. Yep. 1-2.
And okay. Advance of 25%.
There's the 6 point. Oh.
And we know that Dirk knows how to do this.
Yes, he does. He does.
Second time this game. Okay.
Yeah, but he's still in bad position, so it didn't help so much.
Oh, I think it was a really good game and safe throw.
I agree. It's better than being on the roof, no? Yes. It's still tough, but better to be tough holding the anchor than being on the bar and being blitzed. At least there is some hope this way. The other way...
Well, there is a lot of hope with the 23 anchor with three checkers. It means that he's going to have a long time before leaving the last one there. Probably when he's not done.
Fernando could pick another one. Let's see if he manages. No.
No, he won't be picking just yet. Maybe later. Yet. Yeah. Okay. Either or. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, this ace probably was a slight error by Dirk.
Yeah,
he should have played from the 5 point because he cannot keep the 4 points any longer.
Yes. Yes. Good spot, Pojo.
Well, of course, very close decision, so not really a big deal.
Fernando wants to leave a shot, voluntary a shot.
Yeah. Yeah, but I think it's the tactical implications there, isn't it, Bojo, that always having a good eye on really giving yourself maximum chance to be effective in the game.
The problem is next roll he can be in trouble if he plays this.
Yeah. Oh, wow. 1-2.
All the way from 23 to 3.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just about to say.
No,
it's too gammonish.
Yeah, way too gammonish. You just got to bite the rusty bullet and hope for some kind of fan and get lucky here.
And rolling again double fives.
Oh, that would be super. That would be super.
Unless he's on the bar.
Yes.
Okay. Lot saved.
Yeah.
Now double fives and double sixes. Oh, 5-4 is so gammonish, but
3-5,
really bad roll by Fernando. And Dirk has his chances.
He does.
If he gets a 5, he's into the game.
No, he thinks of banana split.
Yeah, I like his thinking here.
Yeah, I do.
I will not.
Not sure if it's correct, but it's good to consider it.
But he's totally with the two checkers there on the 3 and 4 points.
No, I don't think so, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think it's that desperate just yet. Just
because he's still ahead in the race, considering the 4 dead checkers on Dirk's ace point.
And if he doesn't roll a 5, he's going to be in terrible shape on his next roll. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So it looks like.
Hold on.
I didn't say anything.
You got out just before the commentator's curse.
No, I haven't said anything. No,
that's what I said. You got out just before the commentator curse. Just before.
Just before.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, 2 away, 3 away. Uh-huh. Unless something crazy happens here.
No.
Yeah, have to be super crazy.
2 away, 3 away, Dirk.
Yep.
And there again. Under 1 PR point difference.
Smart move by Dirk to gain one decision, but
yes, there is a decision, but this was an automatic play.
He rolled double six.
Yeah. Okay.
So we have 1 point difference in PR.
We do, but.
Slight opening error by Fernando, not playing 2 down, being behind in the score.
Yes. Yes, not opening up for the blitz. Yeah, important.
He still managed to blitz somehow.
Yes. Yeah. And?
Okay. And the blitz should continue, I think.
I agree.
I would not hit on the 3. It's, in my opinion, too ugly. You are ahead in the race. Why to hit? Make the 22, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, good point by Florian, actually. Yeah.
I think that when you blitz, you just blitz.
Yeah. If you're doing it's this.
Outside, Pozo. You're more aggressive than me.
Yeah, no, but I mean, otherwise it's very likely that you will leave a shot first, and then your opponent is going to have a stronger board because you have already your low point. But anyway, he
0-4 in this case to hit his player.
Well played, Florin. Found the best play. Yeah.
Very well.
Yeah, for the reasons stated. Well spotted.
And I'll go all the way.
Yeah.
All the way to the golden point.
Indeed.
A point covered by gold.
Wow, what role that one.
Yeah.
Taking the bar and then whatever is left.
Yeah.
Yeah, but to leave a point in that, it's very difficult.
Yeah, he prevented his opponent to make his 4 point. By leaving a shot.
Oh my, what a shake. Yes. Yes. And? Okay. Looks like it's coming in.
The worst.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. And does he go for the blitz now? I think he does, yeah. The undoubled gammons appearing somewhere in the distance. I can see it just over the hills.
And I must hit on the one now.
Oh, yes. You must go all in for the blitz now. So much of a big reward if it goes well. You can win the set. Fan. Okay. Oh, look at this.
It doesn't do much.
It's not
too bad, making the ace and 9.
I'd take it.
Yeah. And can... Oh, wow.
Oh, there's the fan. Okay, it's not looking good here, Fernando. Can be blitzed out of sight here. Ah, he created the extra builder. Ah.
Okay. Oh, error. Wow. Should have made his 3 points.
Yeah.
And it cost
Fernando
quite a lot.
Fernando is leading in the PR.
It cost the deer because also of the roll. He rolled exactly double three.
Yes. Yeah. So in with two, and then I think you just slot it up.
I slotted two.
Yeah, I think so. Have three builders on it rather than two slotting the 3 point. I think this is positionally a better move.
Okay, suddenly the situation over the board has changed dramatically.
It definitely has.
Just one error by Dirk changed the pace of the game so much.
It has indeed. Yeah. Either or. I think he's just thinking about the numbers a little bit.
Wow, why is an error with this?
Yeah.
Because it's a bit unflexible. It does not save the double aces, and then yeah, it just looks a bit ugly. 3-2-4 formation instead of 2-4-3.
Yeah, I think just one block. Respect the 5 point board. Don't want to be fancy here.
And now, is it?
But
the cube and that is a drop.
Too far behind to take this.
Very easy decision here. Yeah, you're just way too behind in the race here to accept, I feel. Yeah.
And Dirk has missed a cube before the double aces.
Okay, that definitely makes things spicy for the PRs, for sure.
Nah, but it's a very small borderline.
Yes, no, but more in terms of makes it spicy for at the end of the match, who's going to be slightly ahead here. Okay. Yeah, he's got to hit something. He's working out how he's going to do it. Oh. Okay, there's the anchor on the 21. 53.
Making the 3 point, I suppose.
That's my move as well.
Good,
I like
good.
It.
Multiplication.
Yeah. Ah, nice spot, Florin.
Yeah,
I think that's...
Yeah.
I don't think so, because it's not a game and go game.
Oh, yeah, maybe. It's...
Okay.
Just escaping was better, right? Because of no game doesn't pay.
And also there is the blot on Dirk's ace point. Okay, there is the six prime.
Yeah. I'm sure Fernando is going to be delighted with that. Can just free roll now. Secured his six prime. Has Dirk under tremendous pressure?
I can already smell the double match point.
I can smell something else. Even more freaky deaky. I can smell a freaky deaky BG, maybe. Ooh. The speculator.
Yeah, the PR battle, it's very close. Almost the same, even this.
Yeah.
I think that the BG chances here are no more than 1%.
I agree, but when you've been backgammoned with one checker on the bar more than twice, you get more of a feeling for these kind of freaky deaky moments.
Yes, I agree with that.
Yeah. But I agree with your calculus. OK. Okay.
Still double five. That's interesting.
Yeah, some.
What did you say?
Flurry.
What did you say, Florin? Someone mentioning the double five.
No, I only pay attention to this. I don't know if he can avoid it, but it's always a tricky number when you beat
this
him.
This is the commentator's curse.
It is, and there's sometimes in the bearing that you can avoid the dodgy double, but make your bear off position worse. So I wonder,
and
I didn't have...
There is another hit.
Oh, my. Bam! Look at this.
And wow. Now...
Oh, wow.
This now.
Must escape here.
Well, the first thing he needs to make the bar, I agree with that.
I agree with that as well, and it's whether and you...
Probably 24 to 20 and... Yeah, this is also good, but...
Really? Not escaping?
Yeah.
It's a priority to escape, because 4-point board can be hit.
Yeah, 25%. Okay. He found the best play, it seems. Yeah, very well played, Dirk.
Super duper. His instincts on point yet again.
And he's also leading in the PR. I have missed this.
Yes. Yes.
And now he has a decision. So he, well, interesting.
Yeah, he entered on the 20 because you must escape and yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right here, Florin. Got to get out. Nothing to protect against in terms of you're on Crawford anyway, but.
Yeah, well, the 1 point he will make later, Fernando, I think. He
yes.
doesn't get blitz.
Yeah. But.
Difficult 5-1, many options.
Yes. Yes. Many, many options. Four and jump. Hop.
3-5 is the double hit for sure.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Okay.
Escaping was wrong by Fernando because probably of the duplication.
And now Dirk has a chance to get over one PR point difference if Fernando keeps dancing.
Yes, good point, Bojo. Yeah.
Now stop the double force, important. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
He's ready.
6-2. Yeah, I leave now the double force.
I would have left it as well, just having all those builders bearing on it. Okay, he's closed it out.
What a turnaround.
Yeah.
What a commentator's double five score.
Yeah.
Has somebody mentioned double fives?
Yes.
It's one of the 36 roll.
It is, and this is looking like it's going to be a comfortable set win here for Derek. Winning this set to guarantee a point, and then let's see how many points he's going to get with the PR. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. And yeah, they've really toing and froing. Lovely tempo. And that's the set.
The game.
Yeah. It's definitely the set to Dirk there. Wow. Okay. So, Florin, what did you think about that set in terms of the decisions, how they played, how they navigated? What are your thoughts?
Yeah, they also were quite short of time and then because they needed to save some time for the last, so they played quickly and they make some blunder in the end, but okay. Yeah, for me, are quite unexpected that they have blunders. Also, for example, Fernando went out when the checker keeping connection. Usually that's the plan, but you have to look also at the duplication. So probably because of the time he lost some PR there. It was a blunder.
Yeah, and what do you think about going into to set number three with the way they're playing? Can you predict who's going to do well in the next one, or do you think it will be very much like the first two sets?
Yeah, I hope it will be five matches.
Yes, and I'm sure the audience will be hoping for five matches as well. It's looking like it could go that way. It's definitely nip and tuck and very high quality here. So much at stake, wanting to get through to the best of the best final. And Gian Lazzaro, what did you think about this set, how they played, their decisions, how they moved and navigated the board?
Right, this match was more difficult than the first one, and the PR reflected this difficult decision, but they played a good match, and it was very, very interesting and more exciting than the first one. And now I think Dirk is will be a bit ahead in the score. And other interesting match will wait for us.
Yeah, I agree. And Boja, what did you think about that set?
Very interesting, difficult games. A couple of turnarounds during games, including that late hit. Yeah, very exciting match that was. And I'm still waiting for the analyze to be confirmed, but it's being very well played by both players for sure.
Yes, no doubt. They're both on very, very good form here. So, yes, good to see. Wanting to get through the semi-final and get through to the final. One set apiece thus far. Just awaiting the rollout via XG to confirm the points tally and see what the PRs are going to be. I'm sure that's coming soon. Yes, very, very exciting and top quality play. And Florin, just for some of our improving players and viewers that are watching, what do you think is a good way for players to improve their backgammon game?
Well, for example, looking at these matches that are commented, because, okay, it's like a free lesson, no? And it's the same way also in chess. Now it's quite a lot of videos and this kind of stuff. Okay, it's for intermediate players, not for for strong enough players, because they can start on their way. It's more complicated. But for intermediate players to become master, that these are very good, because the computer doesn't tell you why it's a place better than the other, and you don't have all the concepts very clear, it's difficult by yourself to understand. But a strong enough player, let's say, or 5 PR, it should learn also by, can for him it's easier, because you have the concepts. If you are at the same, at that level, you can also go on to study by yourself. This is my opinion.
Very, very nice. And what about you, Gian Lazzaro? Anything else that you can add to some of our improving players in the audience?
I have a different idea. I am very particular in this in this set, because I, for example, I don't play a lot, and I like to study my errors. So, for example, I think that for players that have to improve, it is very interesting to see some didactic videos, not only matches. Of course, matches are more entertaining, but probably they can improve more looking at some video, for example, the ones by Zdenek and an Italian. For I am doing some videos about certain position, and I think it is a good chance to improve.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Gian Lazzaro. Oh, I can see that they've reset the table. So let's get across. Set number three. Best of the best. Fernando against Dirk. Right to get into the final.
So we have an even match till now, right, Bozo?
Yes, I'm just going to tell you now all the details, just to let the players to start so that does not keep them still waiting. What I can say is that, very, very bad analyze by GNU, because GNU said Fernando was playing 3.3 and he was actually playing 1.96, while Dirk played 2.67. So Dirk could not overtake Fernando, even though he won the match. Fernando 2.14, Dirk 1.86.
Wow, game on. Yes.
But I'm not so surprised, because I seen some the blunders that GNU said. I was surprised to be blunders by Fernando.
I think so, blunder.
Yes, and I agree with Bojo that GNU does get it wrong comparative to XG, but we also have to remember that that's what the difference in ply means. So I think the way that the hero site has been set up, it's a lower ply, so you don't have to wait so long for the analyze. And ply means how many moves ahead are you looking in terms of the best play. And I think that we're maybe on a 2 or a 3 ply max here with the GNU. And with plus, that's going to be something like 5 moves ahead or 6 or 7 moves ahead. So it's highlighting the difference in ply between XG and GNU here is what we're seeing.
Now you have a double tiger by Fernando.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now a tough double 5 to play, maybe this one.
Yeah, I'll have to see it from the beginning, but
no, it's not.
Yeah, tough. Okay, well, it's going to be an interesting game. Fernando with 5 in Derek's home board.
Yeah, but Fernando has already a blitzing structure, so it's not good to have so many checkers back when you have already made a 1 point and the 3 points also. Difficult game for him.
I agree. But maybe giving up on the... Oh, okay. He's still okay, still on the front foot. Attacking. Well played. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Wow.
Now, this is very, very good, because the bar point, it's very strong to can escape all the back checker he has.
I agree, Florin. Yeah. Really gives him a good chance to move those back checkers. Still stuck in quadrant 4.
Yeah, because he didn't have the time to play a back game 3, 4 or whatever.
sorry, quadruple okay. one.
While they are producing this super exciting game, just quickly to mention the average PR after the first two matches, 2.33 for Dirk and 2.21 for Fernando. So the two players are playing super strong until that moment.
Excellent. Okay, double deuce. Yeah, 32. Yeah.
I don't like the kid because you have so many checkers. I will just save that checker here.
Yeah. Yeah, he had a different vision on that one.
It's not good to play with many checkers, as I said, in this position.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see what he's going to do. Yeah. Okay. That's going to be a hitter.
Fernando doesn't have checkers to fill in the 4 and the 5 point. This is the problem.
Yes, his armies are separated here. It's going to be tough. 7 over here, 8 on the other side. Okay.
Maybe the 20 is more important, yeah.
Yeah, he's got to maximize his chances to release checkers from his home board. Sorry, from Dirk's home board, not his home board. Yeah. Very interesting to see how Fernando's going to move his checkers into position. Intriguing. Yeah, I like this move from Dirk. Maximizing the distribution of his checkers.
No, come out 23 from the 23.
I agree.
Why he break this point? It can be useful later.
Yeah, maybe he prefer to send the other one back. Aha, he's thinking about which one to hit. Yeah, fewer checkers on this one if he does hit.
Gnu like his move, so.
Ah. Okay. Nice move. Let's see. Having a good think on this one, what to do with the 4, whether he goes here or hits the other one on the other side. I would have done the other one on the other side, but can understand why he did it this way. Yeah. And, yeah, makes the 12. I think that's the move. Yeah.
A difficult decision for bot in this one.
Yeah.
Many options.
Yeah, I think it's that or you just hit and swing it round. Oh, mind you, actually, no, I thought it went to the point, but it doesn't. Yeah.
Oh, powerful.
Very. Oh, my. What a shot. Look at this.
Yeah, very
this.
By bot.
Yeah.
Good enough to make the 17.
Yeah. Yeah, I like your move, Florin. There's the hitter. Bam! Double fives.
And we're the last one.
Yes.
17, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's a smart move. Keeps favorable contact. Yeah. And? Okay, we have a game. Look at this. Who would have thought earlier on with 7 checkers back that we would have come to where we are now. Very interesting. Okay. Fan 32. Ah, okay, maybe a bit too early for that, but
I will keep that on the 14 because I want to make that point, yeah, with the 6.
Ah, yes, I see what you mean, yes, keep the connectivity, and now he can, yeah, and yeah. What's this? 5-6, 5-5, 5-1. Yeah. Okay. And whether he picks, he does. And fan. 43 plays itself, I feel. Yeah. Yeah. And
no 5, so now, ooh.
No, I think someone's rubbed the 5s off on Fernando's dice here. Just in time, yes, just in time. Oh, what a lovely shake that is. Clearing the point, held 5 away, super shake with the 6-4. Just what the doctor ordered. Double 5s. Yeah, yeah. And then, and yes, he's pushing for the gammon.
Yeah, but looks like it's wrong because you must have the gammon and clear also.
Yeah. He's smelling blood, so he wants that G, so he pushed a little bit more.
Oh.
Yeah, not so hot. Yeah. Okay, warming up. Can he save? Will he, won't he? Oh! Now that could be a gammon saver. Big roll. Rolling the girls. And there's the save.
But again, Gnu said it's a mistake, double 5.
Ah.
He didn't want to spend time on this.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. 2-0 here to Dirk. Step number 3. Yeah. Can make a 3-point board as well. But this is a little bit better. Makes it tough for the back checkers to jump away. Yeah. Okay. Advantage to Dirk. Ah, yeah. That's the consolidate. Double 1. Oh, what a shake. What a shake. Yeah.
Now maybe cube, no?
I think so.
Because it's...
Yeah, he's behind, isn't he? 0-2.
The position of Dirk. And he can close.
Yes. Yes, well, good instincts, Florian. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah. And. No, keep that one. Yeah. Yeah, it's not so urgent for the extra builder just yet. And, oh, he didn't make. That's a misser. No, I think 3-point. Yeah.
Oh.
Oh! And you thought it was easy to get past. He gets a second bite of the cherry. Nope, I don't want to hit that checker. Nope. I can't hit you. You wouldn't hit a man with glasses on. Okay. Yeah. Oh, lovely play. Lovely play.
Again.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Now he's forced to hit, I think. There's not much else.
Maybe some duplication. No, nothing.
I think the duplication just gives him more opportunity. I would just do this.
I cannot play 6-5.
Yeah, I think so. Oh, my. Look at this. Really.
And look at this as well.
Yes.
And this as well.
The dice are rigged.
Wow.
Again.
The dice are rigged. Ah, I'm not playing this game anymore.
Wow.
Wow. Fireworks. Look at this. Welcome to Backgammon, folks.
The show is finished now.
Roll up, wherever you are.
What to do now?
Yes.
It seems that Dirk has practiced a lot last days, rolling double aces from the roof when the opponent has only one free spot to leave from the roof.
Yes, indeed, you're right. Yes, these clutch rolls.
Now what to do?
Oh, now this goodness. Is
escape. I would escape here because I have some duplication.
Yeah, I think you're right, Florin. The other way is really horrible, isn't it? Sixes and ones, and
it's as ugly as it could be. It's Gammon is in both ways. I think left Gammon is maybe this way.
Yeah, but you can win more with this one games. I prefer to try to win. If you survive.
Yeah, but this
with
way.
With this one, even if he survives, he doesn't have anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, but otherwise you need to roll 6-4 immediately. Otherwise you are still under attack and there is the second blot you need to save. This is super dangerous.
Yeah, I mean, but it's 4-point board. You see, now we have a game.
Yeah, I like this move.
Yeah, Gnu says 13-3, slightly better, but the two plays are very close. Both awful.
Oh, wow, look at this.
And with that, we couldn't do anything.
And now it changed again.
Did you hear the bell?
I did, yeah. Yeah.
It is the bell for jumping over the prime.
Yeah.
6-1 and 6-5. Know any of them?
Yeah.
And now it's Fernando's turn to leave many shots.
It is. I think he'll leave the 6 duped. So I think he'll go 3-2 if he's going this that way.
18, you cannot break 18 here.
I'm not sad.
I'm not breaking 18 again.
Yeah, it's just a bit too many, isn't it? A few too many. Okay, he's rescued. Saved that one.
Only 6-5, and there are 4 blots after that.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, now save because no blots anymore.
Yeah. Plays itself. Yeah. Oh, okay. Moving forward. Alley-up. Yeah. Okay. Minimalis. Minimalis. Okay, we're racing. Here we go.
Somehow Fernando managed to survive in this position.
Yes, he did. He did.
And now Dirk needs to roll a big double in order to catch up.
He does, but I think that Dirk did well as well with that difficult 6-4 play, keep himself in the set, running out.
Okay, there is the big double, but it's for Fernando. So three away, it is 3-point match.
Yes. Yes, indeedy.
What a game that was. Wow. So exciting.
Very exciting. Yes.
And the first one also with all those checkers back. And Fernando somehow saving the G at the very last moment.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
So this match is the match so far.
He lost the previous one. So for me, the luck is more or less even till now.
Yeah.
I agree. 1-1 apiece and 2-2 in the third, definitely.
Yes. It's all swings and roundabouts, and it does even out. It doesn't even out when backgammon players want it, of course. But over time, it always balances itself out reasonably.
Hey, it's keeping for me.
Clear.
Okay, so Gnu says the cube was early.
Yeah. But I think it's even if it is early, I like the instincts on the front foot asking the question. I like those kind of thoughts. Yeah.
Yeah, probably because of the score, because of the much lower gammon value, actually.
Yes. Yes. So, I like when they have a little push.
I can too early to escape.
Yeah, and
I know
says the escape was better, not by much, but
yeah.
3-2 doesn't hit.
No.
So can he break the 8-point here, or maybe playing with many blots on the low points?
I think it's break the 8 or this and slot the 2.
This one I don't like it.
Yeah. Breaking the anchor, definitely much better. This play was the second best.
8 was much worse, so... In the end, was not so bad what he played.
Yes, but just reducing your power by giving up the 4 prime. And while he only has the 2-point board, the bot prefers the split and slot.
Now, Dirk manages to enter, but Fernando with a great response, making the ace.
Yes.
And now he has all the chances to pick up another one.
He does. Be interesting to see how he navigates here.
Okay, he gave up on that. No.
He want to pick the second one.
Yeah. I'll be intrigued to see.
So it was quite risky to stay there. So
well, actually, not so risky because there is no way Dirk can point on him.
Yes.
Hey, 4-5, 4-1.
Yeah, but then you hit with all fives, 1-4, 2-3, 3-6 is good, double threes is good. So yeah, I think it's worth 5 against 2-point board.
I think so as well. Why not? I think it's out of these two plays.
That's okay as well, getting closer to Crawford.
Yes.
The 3 prime sometimes can work well for many roles.
Yeah, he could fan a lot and he could
as
still...
we saw previously, right?
Yeah. So he doesn't escape now.
Yeah, it's just what's his mind going to settle on here is the question.
And pick up the other one.
But I'm not, because it's not easy to pick it. You see?
agreed.
The 3-point prime.
Yeah. Oh!
Now going to 13 and 10 to 6.
Yes.
And now the mighty 3 prime, 3-point prime.
You know he's not going to jump, right?
But now there's a checker that controls also.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, rewarded for staying. Look at this. And clear. Yes.
Interesting. The double force by Dirk. Actually, GNU preferred to leave nothing, just to enter on 20-21 and to make the deuce point, leaving no any shot.
Ah,
that's very strange for me. I wouldn't play that. I mean, not even think. Because you need something to control the checker.
Maybe it's just reducing a little bit of gammon there, maybe. Just doesn't like it. Likes the contact 6 away. No need to take the extra chances.
Plus, you're making another inner board point for the expecting hitting exchange.
Yes.
He's optimistic about the 3-point prime.
Yes.
Why not?
Yeah, something works, no? 25% of the time works.
Yeah.
Two in, what do you think?
Yeah, I like two in a bit more so, I think, because you can end up wasting more the other way anyway. This only, you know, you're not going to roll that many aces in succession, so slightly prefer it the other way. Take off some of the gammon heat.
All the plays very close, with 10-6 being the best according to GNU.
Okay. So this is going to be a Crawford 2 lead for Fernando.
Dirk still has over 1 PR point lead, but as we saw in the previous match, this means nothing before getting the official analyze.
Yes, good point. Yeah. It's just a nice little guideline for where they're at, but not the ultimate decision. Okay. And there's Crawford. Okie doke, opening exchanges.
So remember the first game, Dirk was so close to go to Crawford, and now he's trailing 3 away, 1 away Crawford himself.
Yes, good point. Yeah. Here we are, set number 3. Yeah. Nip and tuck. Both players jousting beautifully. Wanting to keep their full coat of armor in this duel here. And he hits. Bam!
Yeah, but he doesn't.
Nope. So, yeah. Just pops one out. 43. He can hit again. On 14. He sees it differently.
I think 14 is better.
I think 14 is better. Keep that midpoint. He may rue that decision in a few more rolls. Another hitter. Bam!
Another interesting game.
Yes.
And for the first time since the beginning of this match, the difference in the PR is less than 1 point.
Yes.
But there's no point. So many shots here hitting and doesn't have anyone any point. Okay, he can make one first time now, I hope.
Yeah. Let's see how it pans out. Okay.
I like this because otherwise there is no good fourth one. But who doesn't like it?
I like the fact that he made the five. I wasn't paying attention. Be wrong.
In this kind of position, he can be wrong.
Yeah, and it's not the kind of positions that you see regularly in the backgammon here.
Who is bearing off on the top right corner?
Yeah, it looks that way, doesn't it?
I think this game will destroy the LPR.
Yes, but who does that favor? Does that favor Fernando or does that favor Dirk here?
Actually, I don't have a favor here because both sides are difficult to play.
Yeah.
I think it does favor us and all viewers because we are going to experience some very, very exciting game.
More difficult for Fernando because he doesn't have points. Dirk has an easy, clear plan to make the important points and to escape, but Fernando not having any point. But
that's just changed. Yes, block. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, my apologies. I thought you had two more. But all right.
I think six sixes in one row would be a bit too much.
Yes, I agree with you. Fan! Okay, oh, there's the cover. Yes.
There is the cover and there is the return.
Wow! Only had four numbers to hit. Did it comfortably.
Yeah. So what?
Yes, the force is strong with Fernando at the moment. Yes.
This is a terrible 3-1. Again, the 3-point prime.
Yes, the 3-point prime is causing havoc for the opponent today.
And they fought another 3-1.
Oh.
5-4 looks much better.
Okay, intelligent play here from Fernando. Recognizing Fernando recognizing he only needs a point
where
to win match.
Is the three
he wants to keep that checker there on the 3-point? I didn't think it's so important.
I think his first idea making the ace and letting Dirk dance.
Yes, it helps. Yeah. Again, fantastic natural instincts, recognizing what he has to do. 1 point away from winning the set.
Make the bar. Yeah.
I like it.
Now here. I think making the three looks better.
Yeah, it's better.
I think it's better as well, just as a. As more team.
Gnu says, well done, Fernando. And Gnu says, you guys in the studio have to study more.
Oh. that's definite for me, for sure.
Thank you, Gnu.
Thank you. Yeah. But where's the tree?
All the way with the one on the.
Where is the tree?
Every time the tree is a problem.
It is.
Yeah, but with the checker on the six,
I think only
three.
Two down. I don't see it well, but two down is a triple shot.
It is, but what's the alternative? It's much worse, isn't it?
I can't think of an alternative. Otherwise, it's three blocks. This is the only safer play, but it's safer only now. But the next row, it's not going to be safer. So this looks like the play down. Because in case he doesn't get hit, he has solved his problems.
Yeah.
Yeah, but,
but if he does.
That play. No, this one.
No way. It's either two down or leaving the blot on the 6-point.
Yeah. I agree.
He went for that.
He did.
He likes it.
Well played.
Yeah, very well played.
Well done, Fernando. Finds it again. No surprise, of course, with his supreme talent. Okay. He'd love to alley-oops. He's done it. Jumped the hell out of there. And he's got missed. Can he save it?
Well, that was unbelievable. How to say.
Did many problems for Fernando because of missing 6 and 5 points.
Yeah, it's the dodgy threes again, isn't it? It's been a problem.
Every time.
Yeah, oh, very reasonable shake. Now, can you bring
the ace here?
I would as well. You need the contact. Don't play pure. He's running out of position on the other side.
Yeah. We played 13-7.
Okay, that's also. But if you play like this, stay on 17.
Don't think there's any need to give up and play pure here. Just challenge your opponent for this role. He's got a raggedy position. I would have challenged him more the other way.
Strange Dirk played this such a way. Let's see.
Yeah, I wouldn't have given up anchor.
But the other, what we said, were both almost the same. 13.
Okay, we have even PR. And...
Yes.
Oh, what happened here? Dirk managed to hit. Wow.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Oh, there's the six prime. We have more action. Okay. Yeah. I can't call it. It's too close to call. Both players want that final. And it's getting even more interesting in terms of their time bank as well. Both with under a minute. Fernando closer to 30 seconds. Okay, all pretty straightforward from here.
DMP is coming.
Yes, it is. Nice. Call it 1.1 games from here.
Another turnaround, this time in Dirk's favor. Of course, he had many chances which he missed earlier in the game, but at the end, he found a way to win the game.
He did. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Great one. Yeah. Okay, there's the four prime.
Okay, oh, both of them rolling very well at the moment.
Wow, Igno doesn't like the 6-1.
Yeah, prefers to make the bar and don't give him any shots. Yeah.
It's a DMP, so making the 5 is more the game on go.
Yes, nice spot, Bojo. Correct.
Now 8-5 and going up. I don't think so.
Yeah.
This should be the play.
Yes.
Now Fernando needs to go to the edge of the prime. Yeah, he has a stronger board. Not anymore.
You've got a 5-point prime. I've got a 5-point prime. Oh!
How many points prime you set?
Oh, 6.
It's not easy because many times he likes to make the 2, but I will play this.
Yeah, I think so. You just do this and try and roll your 1-6 as quickly as possible.
Okay, now he needs approximately 7 rolls from here to get in safety the last checker.
Yes.
Hard because needs a 1 and a 6.
Yeah.
Maybe he gets hit and gets more timing. Yeah, here is the ace, but the 4 is not nice.
I doesn't have time to think here. It's difficult, this one.
Yeah, I think you make the deuce.
This is more important to make the one for the MP. I will play the other.
Yeah,
difficult one for sure.
Very difficult.
If this one, every big number, then it will crash.
This way, if he doesn't roll the deuce, then you love it. Okay.
But not rewarded anyway.
Yeah.
But Dirk found the best play.
Well played, Dirk. Very well played. Recognize the importance of moving up with the ace. Increase the winning chance.
Okay, look at this. He's going to attack now.
He does.
Yes, attack.
Yeah, it gives him too much if you don't.
Play this one.
But it gives him sixes and ones, doesn't it, to get away? Okay. So he held. Well played. And now he's ready. Big advantage, Fernando. Look at this.
What a game. Can Dirk again find a way?
Wow, Fernando make a blunder with Forza.
Fernando with a blunder.
Yeah, because he didn't close the prime. He didn't see, probably.
Oh, that's my department, not seeing the six primes.
Also, we didn't. So.
Yeah. Yeah, he could have. Yeah. But with not much time, that's understandable, of course. Yeah.
And it is now that time management is very important in these 5-point matches. It's not like in 13 can be high cube or something, but in 5-point, it's always got to go close to use all your time if it's not easy game, like finishing a few moves.
And Fernando, monster favorite here, with six checkers already.
Yes.
Off.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he will probably extend his lead comfortably here.
I agree with you, Bojo.
Man, no, because Dirk, he would get almost 1 point here if it's confirmed analysis.
Okay, so that's the set to Fernando. Nip and tuck all the way. Both players really want to make it through this match and get themselves into the final. So, Florin, what did you think about that set in terms of how they played, their decisions?
Well, they have a difficult decision in one game, and I was surprised they didn't make errors. They're all a few small errors. So I predicted it would be destroyed the PR, but I was wrong because they played well. And okay, they keep playing under three, so very, very good.
I agree. I think they're doing fabulous here. Normally, with a couple of back games, that would be enough to really explode your PR the wrong way. But these guys obviously really know their way around a backgammon board, and effortless ease under three with a couple of back games thrown in. So yeah, fabulous stuff. And Jean Lazaro, what did you think about that set in terms of how they play, their decisions, navigation around the board?
Another difficult match, but they played very, very well. They confirmed, but it was not necessary, that they are really top players. Of course, for Dirk, it is clear for everybody. For Fernando, maybe it is not so clear for everyone, because he is less known, but he's really a top player.
There's no doubt about that, Jean Lazaro, and I think that would have been the case pre-Monte Carlo, but I think he's arrived and shown the backgammon community how fabulous a player he is, And I'm sure that he's going to be much more well-known now, for sure, with his performances online and being part of Team Italia twice in being victorious world champions live and online. So, yes, his notification in terms of his pedigree is just getting better and better, just like a fine glass of wine. He gets better with time. Okay, and Bojo, what did you think about that set in terms of the game, the decisions, the navigation around the board?
Yeah, it's getting more and more exciting. It seemed in the beginning that Fernando lost his concentration, but then he probably got a bit lucky, but he managed to find some absolutely great decisions later in the match. And Dirk played constantly very strong from the beginning till the end. So yeah, we are waiting for the analyze to be reconfirmed, and we are going to announce it very soon.
Yeah, so I look forward to that. Sounds good. Yes, and Gian Lazzaro, not including the lovely CNB circuit in Italy, what have been your favorite tournaments around the world to consider going to?
At the moment, I have played just the World Championship, the WBGF World Championship, but I would like to go to Cyprus. I think it is a very interesting interesting tournament, but I don't know, it's my feeling. I don't like too much very crowded tournaments. For example, the best tournament are BMAB tournament with 10-20 players. I am not for very, very crowded tournaments. But of course, it is tournaments like Cyprus, Monte Carlo give you the possibility to see a lot of very strong players. So they have a good appeal.
They do, and I must say, Gian Lazzaro, Cyprus in November at the Merritt Park Hotel in Carinha comes highly recommended. And there is wonderful because aside of the backgammon, you have so many things you can do. You have more than one swimming pool. You have an area to be outside. You have little huts where you can gather and have nice talks. There's so many different places to spend your time. So if you do have a consideration and you do have the time, I think that you should try and get yourself along to the Merritt Open in November. Comes highly recommended from my previous experiences of going to that tournament. It's very, very enjoyable. And Florian, what about yourself? Previously, what have been your favorite tournaments to travel to around the world when you're spending time with your backgammon?
Well, I don't have one tournament that I prefer, because as I said, I prefer to go to new tournaments. But okay, if I have to choose, maybe for the organization and how is the field, it's the Nordic Open.
But
it's quite expensive, so okay, this is important. Okay, I went anyway twice there. But I don't know the new tournaments. I haven't seen to Dubai. I would like to go there, but it's not clear if it's done or not. I was sitting is postponed. For sure, I don't like much Monte Carlo because too crowded, too expensive. See, Cyprus is fine. It's okay. It's nice. I mean, but I have been there three or four times, I don't remember.
Sure. And Bojo, yourself, do you have any of your favorite places to travel to, backgammon-wise? Okay, we'll come back to him. I think he's knuckling down to working out the rollouts in terms of the previous set. So we'll let him concentrate on that. Let's have a look. Nope, they're not ready to resume yet. Okay, I have another question here for you, Gian Lazzaro. Some may call it a little bit controversial, but I think it's a good question to ask. What's your opinion on live play in terms of the dice rolling? When somebody rolls out of turn or in the wrong manner, do you feel that the dice roll should stand, or should the opponent have the option for calling the roll to stand or re-roll? What's your thoughts?
I am a bit... particular in my thinking, because I think that in backgammon rules are not followed very strictly. Players think that they can do what they like instead of follow rules. For example, players have already started.
Ah, okay, let's get... Oh, well, thank you for that, Gian Lazzaro. We'll come back to that question, maybe another date. Let's get over there. Not waste any time. Set number four. You're right. Okay, here we go.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you, Bojo. Welcome back.
Okay, sorry. My connection was lost for just a few seconds, but then I needed to restart everything.
Yeah, no problem. Yes. Okay. Set number four. And I can sense both these players would love to win this match and get through to the final to face Hideaki Ueda. They're really concentrating well.
Okay, so back to the numbers. Dirk Schiemann played 2.15 and Fernando Braconi played 2.81. So the overall score at the moment, Dirk Schiemann 2.69 points, Fernando Braconi 3.31 points. So the two players are still pretty close. It's very important who is going to win the matches.
Yes, and this has been really evenly balanced, isn't it, from set one now into set four. I think this has been the most evenly contested number of sets we've seen thus far in Best of the Best. It's wonderful stuff, really nip and tuck here. No inch or quarter given by either of these two supreme players. Okay.
So, sorry to interrupt you. Average PR for Dirk, 2.26 after the match number three. Average PR for Fernando, 2.46. So they still play under 2.5. Well played both.
Very well played both. Highlighting their top class play.
And I think it's a cube here, no? Probably it's clear with a cube.
I think it is a cube, yes. You have a good racing lead. You can pop that checker out very comfortably. Yeah.
But he didn't. So let's see now. After this ugly five.
I think now you must know. You've got 20 shots there. Okay. No. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, difficult to cube when your opponent has such a strong board, and then even if you jump into the outfield, there is no bridge unless you roll double sixes. So I kind of understand why he is more conservative.
Yeah, but when he was on the bar, I think for me it was a cube after, no, but before, yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
there is the 006 talking about that.
Yes, it's different. This time it's the commentator's compliment.
Now it's too good.
Yeah, it looks that way, doesn't it? With such a humongous racing lead. You're covering with nines, twos, and fives. Easy pass if you do cube. Ah, and the cube's already in play as well. Yes. Now we can, yeah.
He goes for the game on.
Yeah, I think so. I think you kill your gammons by cubing out.
Any four creates problems. So for me, I would have cube for me.
Okay, I think he may recube now that he's come in. I think, yeah. Yeah. And I don't think you can take this.
It's a drop to me.
Looks like a drop, but okay.
I think it's
not easy to break that contact.
Yeah, but I think at best you're going to get a single shot, and then when you miss, it's generally, or not generally, a big percentage of the time, it's game over.
Yeah, he took.
He did take. He knows his position a lot better than myself.
It's not a mistake, but it's a big mistake, but still one small.
Yeah, I think just a humongous racing lead, and at best you're going to get a single shot once and that's it. I just don't think there's enough shot value, really.
No, but not only one, because maybe also with the 4 point can still lose the foot later.
Yeah, it's very unlikely.
Probably, I think. How many gammon there are? Probably are too many.
Pay now or pay later?
Pay now for me.
Pay now for me too.
Pay now, yeah.
That is the pay.
Why did I pay to eat this food? Why?
We finish soon this one.
It's going to finish very soon. Wow, this is huge because it could be a monster swing the other way, couldn't it? If Dirk
and wins again and again and again, Fernando finds his way.
Wow,
he does. Wow, look at this. Oh my, there's the closeout. But it could be a double-edged nightmare sword where he maybe won't have enough time to shave his PR down to be competitive.
But probably it's not enough for Fernando because the PR would get 1 point here.
Yes. At least it's better for him this way where he gets the point for winning the set. Yeah. Yeah.
One thing is clear. Dirk cannot win the challenge without winning a match.
Yes.
But he won already one match.
I mean, from now.
From now. Yeah. Okay. Big advantage, Fernando.
Can he get a shot? No.
No. He's racing. Okay, a much quicker set this one. One game wonder. Okay, two off. Yeah. Load up the four. Yeah. Okay, two off. I'd load the four again. Yeah. Okay, and that's the set. That's the definite set. Wow, that was fast. That was fast for sure.
It was very fast.
It was not really much to talk about because there weren't that many decisions.
I think this one is clear 1 point PR for Dirk. So we can freeze the situation.
Yes. Yes.
What is 0.70 points up, Fernando, right?
I'm not too sure. Maybe when Bojo jumps back on board, we can find out a bit more information. But as that was the one game wonder, we can go back to Gian Lazzaro and continue with the when the opponent makes an illegal roll. And we can go back to that question again, if that's all right.
Yes, but your question was about legal moves or...
No, the dice, the premature roll, when the premature dice roll is the main one. Do you think that it should be...
Yes.
When you do a premature roll, should the dice roll stand? Or should it be the opponent has the option that the roll stands or you re-roll? What are your thoughts, Gian Lazzaro?
I think that the rules is that... that the roll stands, but the player can the players that didn't make the illegal behavior can think without the clock running. I think this is the rule, but in general, I think that. Respect of rule are not enforced in a backgammon, and I see very, very, very often, for example, players which who move the checkers with two hands or move the checkers with one hand and press the clock with the other. A lot of behaviors that are that I don't like because probably because I was a chess player, but I am used to more clear situation. I don't like to. To have to check the hands of the opponent to see if they are doing things well or not. Or for example, players who raise the dice when I have not moved. And a lot of things that I don't like, but I have seen that they are considered quite normal. They are not enforced, the rules. And so, I don't know, probably I'll have to... to adjust to this this behavior, but I don't like it. I would like that rules were followed in a stricter way.
Thank you, Gian Lazzaro. Shall we move to the table?
Oh yes. Thank you, Bojo, for the interjection. Yes, let's definitely get across. As this is the final set, I believe, set number 5. So all to play for. We've been building up just to this moment. Set number 5 to determine who's going to make the final of the best 2022. Game on. Here we go. All righty. Oh, lovely shake. Yeah, by Fernando. Double ducks.
Okay, in the meantime, again, very different numbers compared to GNU, but this time at least the winner is the same. We had just a second. Yeah, we had 2.90 for Dirk and 6.33 for Fernando, which is was reconfirmed by everyone who is working on that. At the same moment, GNU said 0.something against 4. So crazy stuff.
Yeah, that cube that Fernando took was too good. Was more too good. But okay, was not so huge, was because of the score. 0.40. 100.
Yeah, Fernando is leading before the last match. 4.31 against 3.69. Dirk definitely needs to win the match and not to get outplayed by too much. I'm going to tell you soon exactly by how much is enough for Dirk to win.
Thank you, Bojo. Yeah. So, all to play for. So much at stake. The winning line is so fine and so much more to happen, but only one set left to do it in. So very exciting, very interesting. Let's see. Oh, and there's the fan.
Very interesting, the cue from the bar for Fernando here with three checker back. I will have cubed this.
Yeah, I think he has to pop a 6 to the 18, in my opinion. Yeah, I think that has to be. Yeah. Can we do it this way? Give up the mid with 3 on 24?
No, I don't like it.
I'm not so keen. I think this is the way. Got to take the pressure off your 24 point and do it while he's on the bar. Oh, what a shake from Fernando. Wow. Oh, the riposte.
I don't know. I'm not sure. I prefer this because
Yes, I think you're right, Florin. This definitely puts the more pressure on the position. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. And then.
Because the back checker of Fernando, they can escape very easily. So if he doesn't enter, it's almost.
My gut says that this is a pass.
For me, it's a pass.
Yeah, I think the power of the perfect four-point board structure, the escaping value and the control is just a bit too much. Yeah.
Yeah, but we're not a big one. 0.56.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Just very tough to get ahead in that one, I feel. So, good decision to let it go by Dirk. Okay, so some action going to happen here. Yeah.
I think it's double and probably it's a pass also because it's dangerous.
I agree with you, Florin. I agree. And he can't play on because if he doesn't roll the 5 or the 6 to hit, then or the 2 and the 1, it's
It's wrong. Why it's wrong? Because for me, it's double pass. Probably it become too good. For me, it's double pass anyway, but computer. Yeah. Otherwise.
Yes, I agree with you.
No, it's a tape.
Ah, okay. What am I talking about? What a fool. Yeah. Still have decent position.
Small take by 35.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, wow. Look at this.
Okay, well, anyway, was Fernando good to understand it's a take?
Oh, lovely shake. Look at that. It's made the pull up to the bumper, baby. No.
No
way. Pull up to the bumper, baby. Yep. No. Nothing but the 22 will do.
Wow, it's not a mistake.
Wow, super play. How does he know?
It's big.
How does he know? Super duper.
Any blot, yeah.
No blot, and the frustration point, 6 away, has far more value than getting to the edge. So forget my pull up to the bumper, Grace Jones nonsense. What a play by Fernando there, sensing the best move at the right time. Wonderful stuff.
Actually, yes, because to play with 3 on the 22 usually is not good, but in this position, it was. Okay, now he didn't roll well with double 4. It's crushing.
Yeah, but he's still well in the game, and he's got lots of...
Yeah, but he was probably even ahead without this, because he had a good crash. And...
Yeah.
Okay, I have the update about what is necessary to the two players. Of course, Fernando is going to the final in case he wins the match. And in case Dirk wins the match, he should not
the 4 points. I like this play.
Okay.
The line is wrong.
Yeah.
Because he could make the 4 point, yeah.
Yeah.
This is very costly in terms of PR for Fernando.
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
Because this one could be a short match as well.
Yeah. Could be. All depends how it pans out from here. Oh. Okay, he's on his way. 05. Okay, there's the 4 point board.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay.
Oh, so he hits now.
Oh, wow. Who would have imagined? Now look at this. Okay, now you're going to have to be brave.
What to do here? Hit?
Yeah, you have to hit. You have to hit. Can't not hit. And he's ready. He is ready.
Is 19, no? 19, 15, what else?
No, I think from 18. I play this one.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, fan. Off ski. Yeah. In. Yeah. I think, yeah, just 2 off. Yeah, ramp up the pressure. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Yeah. Pushes further ahead. Fan. Yeah. Okay.
So five throws he needs.
Yes. Okay, that's a lot more comfort, and so's that. Destiny in his own hands.
There is one double.
1, 2, 3.
Definitely 5-4, yeah. Well spotted. And the gammon is saved.
It is very important.
So once again, for Dirk to go to the final, he needs to win the match, and he needs to not get outplayed by over 0.62 points or 62 millipoints.
Okay, wow.
He's ahead. So it looks like who wins the match would get to the final.
Oh, it's too early for that, Florin, but I like the way you're thinking. It only takes one boo-boo or a little misstep and it all changes again. So, but yes, yes, definitely advantage PR-wise for Dirk thus far. But I'm sure Fernando's going to be chomping at the bit to get his PR normalized in a better manner. Let's see.
He needs to move from 24 here because it's otherwise it can be too ugly.
Yeah, I agree.
Hey, the 5 will be too hit on the 1. It was not easy. But even 11-6, it was good enough.
Ah, okay. Double 2, what a shake. 1-2. Oh, wrong one.
Not easy, this one.
Yeah.
This must make the 22 also, or to make the 4.
This looks good, but leaves a lot of shots.
It does, but maybe the strength and power of the position is enough to open up like that.
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah, I like his vision on that one. Everything else was a little bit too awkward and giving shots in the wrong regard. But this way, he powered up the board. Yes, he gave many opportunities, but he's got the perfect 4-point board as compensation.
Okay, Dirk goes here for the safe play.
Yes, respecting Fernando's power board.
Okay. Now double hit, I think.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. And in with one.
What now? Cube?
I don't think so. I think you kill your gammon here. I would roll. I think it's an easy pass. I think you take a pot shot here and try and make the board and get the cheeky gammon.
But I will cash here because.
But why? You've got 4s, 3s, 2s, and 1s to cover, and he's already got 2 on 24. You just killed a gammon, I think, straight away. You've got to maximize
the
chance.
Too many gammons here.
Oh, there are definite.
There are many shots here. 3, 6.
Yeah, but you just killed you killed a value of the position too much when it's massively in your favor. It's a gift, I feel, to cash. You're letting your opponent off the hook a bit too much.
There is the cube.
Yeah.
Now I don't know.
Yeah, I still think it was too good.
For me, it was
okay.
Better.
He missed the one before, as Florin correctly pointed, and this one was already too good.
Well played, Florin. I take back everything I said.
Well, you were right, Eric, that it was too good this time.
Thank you.
So now Fernando is back in the PR battle.
Yes, yes. Many more.
After this blunder, surprise at the second move.
Yes, but as commentated, I thought this could happen. At some stage, that's all it takes. Just one move changes everything.
Yeah, because he needs an anchor at his core.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm surprised that Dirk didn't anchor here on 22.
Yeah.
And now Fernando with a mistake.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. I seem to be a bit nervous. This game, which is very normal because it's all on the table.
He went for the game on here. I mean, if you hit, you take many rolls from white to do something, for Dirk to do something good. But it's not right for sure, because I'm stuck too many on that 13.
Yeah, fan. Oh my, look at this. One, two, one.
It's getting game on it, suddenly.
Four, it is. What can Dirk do here under pressure? One, two. I think his first thought, yeah. Okay, now he wants to get missed. Get the hell out of dodge. Get out of there. Get out of there. Even being behind in race, I think you have to get off the hot spot. Okay, yes, okay. Okay, 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 Corral.
Okay. So finally in a good position.
Yes, he's a lot happier now.
Fernando needs to go to 22.
Yeah, this is good. No.
Oh, look at this, the 6 prime.
Yes, there it is.
Yeah, there, but it's not over yet, because it's 6 prime is too much outside, let's say. It's difficult to make the 4 points here.
Now, 8-3 and 6-4.
Yeah, this is the move. No doubt about it.
And now dancing forever.
Yes. And he's just.
That would be my strategy. Dance here.
No, I don't. I think he wants to enter to hit something else, not to go for Gammon here.
But he doesn't need a Gammon.
That's actually a good roll. Can't shake any more fruit from the tree. 2, 3, 4. Okay, so he remakes. Yeah. Everything looking fine. Oh, 1, 2, still has enough. 3, 4.
But better don't row it again.
And he'll look at the natural pointing number as well. Okay, he's not looking at that one either. Okay.
6-1, the best row probably.
Yeah, and this is going to give Dirk some big advantages, because he's shaving his PR down and Fernando's not getting any decisions here.
No, he has a decision.
No, he has one.
He does. The question is, does he hit?
What's the point of
it? So, because we don't gain much.
Don't hit and wait for the opponent to roll double fives.
Exactly.
You've seen it, Bojo, huh?
Yeah, I've rolled it many times.
Also, double four also is bad.
Yeah.
3-1 is not one of those.
No. Okay. Yeah, fan. Close.
In control, let's see. Fernando needs a big double right after Dirk opens up his high points.
Yeah,
I think bear off one.
Yes, definitely.
Only 6-5 is really a problem. No, I don't think so.
I think it's the other way. Yeah, this gives a little bit more chance. Yeah, he's confident now. Yeah, rolling ahead.
And it seems that Dirk Schiemann, the defending champion, is in the final.
It's a decent guideline, of course, on the predictor score or the predictor bot, where we're giving it, of course, but.
Let's wait for the official analysis.
He sweat a lot for this victory.
if he, yeah, it's very probable that he is going to be victorious, but let's wait and see what the higher court of appeal says when we rinse it through the machines. So, Florian, what did you think about that final set?
Well, in the end, it was as expected. It was a very close match. Fernando won 3, I think, and Dirk made 2. Dirk played better, so in the end, I said that he deserved to go on. But it was, as we expected, was not easy win. And okay, for me, it was everything nice because let's see the final PR, but because it increased a bit at the end. But they play under 3 for sure, the average.
Yes, it's looking that they both played well. Of course, we'll find out a bit more about that in a moment. But it is about that time for Gian Lazzaro's summary.
A very exciting match, very well played. I am just a bit puzzled because Fernando made too many mistakes at the beginning of some matches, and I think it is very, very strange. Because apart from those start of matches, he played very, very well. But sometimes he started at PR 10, 15. It's not normal. And I think he lost his match partly because of these mistakes. But of course, both players played very well. Congratulations to Dirk, which I think played better than Fernando, more regular, and deserved to win. Fernando has something to adjust because I don't know, some strange mistakes. At some points he was out of the flow. He didn't. It seemed he didn't understand the position and make a lot of mistakes. Very, very strange. But very enjoyable match. Very, very well played. So he can be happy.
Yeah. Not so many mistakes, Gian Lazzaro, in the end, because he played how much? I think under 3 in the end, no?
Yes, but in I think at least in 2 matches, he started the first game with a lot of mistakes. A lot of mistakes for him, of course. For me, it would be perfectly acceptable. But I am not saying that he played badly, but at certain points he didn't play at his normal level, and it is strange. I think it is something he has to think about.
Yes, very exciting indeed. It's looking very probable that it will be Dirk Schiemann through to the final of the Best of the Best 2022, but we'll wait for confirmation of that, of course. Sure, that will be coming soon once we've got the final confirmations. Yes, and I'll pitch the same question to Florin. Florin, what's your thoughts on premature roles? Are you more in favour of the role stands, or do you prefer to have the option that the role stands or the opponent re-roll? What's your thoughts?
I don't have a strong opinion. I've changed it many times because I always don't like when players can't use it tricky. I remember before clocks, when players were just putting the other hand. So for me, the rules should go in this direction to not let, let's say, smart, or how to say, or sly players make profit of these rules. That's the most important thing, in my opinion.
All right, thank you very much. And Bojo, do we have the update?
We have the update, and we have our second finalist. And this is the defending champion, Mr. Dirk Schiemann from Germany. Congratulations, Dirk. Last match, 2.57 for Dirk, 3.32 for Fernando. The total score of the match is 5.57 points for Dirk against 4.43 points for Fernando. And the total average PRs are very strong. Congrats to both. 2.34 for Dirk and 2.85 for Fernando.
So, Gianazzo, with the numbers, do you still think Fernando didn't play at his level?
I am not saying he played bad. I told him a lot of times. I think that Fernando can play better than he plays, and can win much more. I think he's a fabulous player, and he can do better, and he has to do. Probably I am a bit severe, but I think it is an incredible talent, and he should use his make the best use of his talent. I think he can be really one of the few best players in the world. I have seen a lot of times him explaining position, and I am really astonished hearing him. So I am a big fan of Fernando.
So congratulations to Gian Lazaro for your player, your big fan of playing so well. 3.03 in the quarterfinal and 2.85 in the semifinal. So amazing performance by Fernando.
For me, was Dirk that played very well. I mean, he normally played, I don't remember, 270 or something, but this time he played below a lot. So playing 230, difficult for Fernando, I think, to win the PR. But with 235, Fernando could be closer if Dirk have played, let's say, something happened with Dirk. I have seen a few matches where he made mistakes, but this time he didn't. I mean, he was very steadily playing under 250 almost every match.
Yes, no doubt. And it's about that time for some interesting positions. And we have the first position, which is a 2-1 to play. And Florian, we'll let you start with this one.
This I only missed during the match, but I saw that it's a mistake. Probably for me, I would have played to save the blot and 24-23.
Yes, and we like your move, which is the top move. Would you add any additional thoughts for some of our not so strong players for having a bit more insight and your reasons why?
But no, because here it's the NATO. I mean, this could be an overplay. With you do something like 22-4 to 21, so it's not a problem for let's say not so strong players to miss this, which the risk is on the other side to overplay, because you need to have three checkers on the 13. It's always good. So usually not save that blot when you have many there, but when you have only two, it's always good to save, in my opinion, the blot.
Sure. And Jan Lazaro, what's your thoughts on this 2-1?
I don't know. I would have made the move, the flooring move, without thinking, because for me it is completely natural. Dirk is quite ahead in the race, so why searching complication? Why give Fernando the possibility to hit the second checker? I would save the blot, and of course a spare in the mid is very important, and I would leave just the struggler to wait for the moment to escape. But I don't understand Dirk's move.
Yes, I agree, Jean Nazar. I think it was maybe just a cheeky duplication of the threes here. He maybe just outfoxed himself a little bit. And I'm sure if he showed in the position 100 times, he would get it right most of the time. It's just one of those outfoxing moves where you can slightly trick yourself, I think, in this regard. All right. Next position, please, Jan Nazaro. Okay, so here we have a cube decision. All right. So, Bojo, I'll let you open this one.
I'm not sure we have a cube decision, or at least I see it.
Okay, there is, I think there is some the problem three. Because, yes, because the first, probably the first, the first position was not the one selected by Bojo. I made a mistake.
Okay.
So here is
the 1-3.
Yes, this is the first position. Yes.
Ah, okay.
So we got one extra. Thank you.
We've got a bow. We have a bonus.
We had one position bonus, which was also an interesting position with all those duplications and keeping the connectivity. But okay, here 1-3. It's complicated a little bit because against the 4-point board, we definitely prefer not to give extra new blots, but on the other hand, going to 21 against all those forces in the outfield, it's just too dangerous. So we need to stay on the 24, and if we know that we have to stay on the 24, then only possible option is a 6-3, because otherwise we leave a lot more shots, and 6-3 is also unstacking. So yeah, a bit unusual to leave another blot in such a position, but just way too dangerous going to 21, because on 21 we are going to be attacked with anything. Even the loose hits are already very dangerous. So funny or not, staying on the 24 and slotting the 3-point is actually the safe play.
Okay, thank you very much, Bojo. Any additional thoughts here, Florin? Florin, you still with us? Okay, so Jean Lazaro, anything else to add in regards to this 3-1?
I think that Bojo explained it very well. It was not an easy choice. Of course, otherwise Dirk would have made it without doubts. But it is yes, to leave the second block, it's better probably because it is not clear that that Fernando can eat the block. In the other case, it's very, very likely that he'll hit the struggler and will have the possibility to close the fifth point or fifth inner board point. So it is much riskier than leaving the second block, as Bojo correctly pointed out.
Here, thank you very much, Gian Lazzaro.
Yeah, sorry, I lost the connection. Yeah, I agree with Gian Lazzaro here.
Ah, you're back. Okay. Okay, good. Good. Yes, wonderful. Okay, next position, please, Gian Lazzaro. Okay, so Florian, you can open this one up. Over to you.
Yeah, I remember this. It's it's for me clearly double, and I would have passed it. If I remember, I said that it looks like a big mistake. Usually, I roll this prime against prime all double take. But for me, it was too stripped for me, Fernando. But he was brave and good enough to take, because I would have passed because we fear of crashing next roll without a six.
Yes, here, and I think I may have followed you here with the same thoughts, Florian, in that we can see that our position is deteriorating on the other side, and we're going to be in danger of reducing our inner board to be worse if we don't roll a six. And I may have well been made the same decision as you and let this one go. But I know from watching these super duper players and gaining a bit more experience that it's not quite as bad as it first appears. Because really, look, we have the better board. We've got the 5-point board. Yes, we're going to potentially come out when we roll a six, but our opponent still has two checkers on the 24. And that's what XG is saying here, is that we have the race, we have the stronger board by quite a bit, and there's still a lot of work for White to do in the position to close things out or really make it difficult for us. So that's why it's showing it's such a big take. Which would seem surprising based on the way things look here and now. I was just about to invite. Yes, please do.
Thank you, Eric. So the reason for me to add this position was mainly that GNU on Heroes, as well as the lower analyze levels on XG, they say that the position is a no double. So I did analyze with plus and then with row out, and it's a clear or a very small cube because of losing the market. And this is what we have to learn from here. As much as possible, analyze on deeper settings, because otherwise we might learn wrong some positions which can be general, like this one, prime versus prime. We are going to experience similar positions many times, and then it's good to just know where the doubling point is and not to miss it every time just because we studied from the lower level of analyze.
Very good point, Bojo. Lovely addition. Okay. Next position, please, Jan Nazara.
I think that was all.
And oh, so that was the final position?
We have one more, yeah.
Oh, this is the final now?
Yes.
Ah, okay. So we have a 5-2. So, Florin, we'll let you start this one.
Here I said it. It's clearly for me. It made the 22 and don't hit 13-8. This I remember.
Yes, I do remember.
Ahead in the race and to hit on the back checker. I mean, not on the first one, because to hit on the 20 it's another thing on the 5 point, but to hit on the 3 point is not worth for me in this position.
Agreed. Jean Lazaro, any additional thoughts?
Okay, for me, the same. I wouldn't have a thought about hitting. For me, it's very natural to make the anchor and play from the mid. I am ahead in the race, and okay, the position is I have the ace point, so it could lean to a blitz, but it is I think too early blitz. I would not blitz in this moment.
Okay, fantastic, Jan Lazara. Any final thoughts here, Bojo?
Well, when we blitz, we blitz. So I would have got this one wrong, as I said in the last stream as well. I would have played the second best move because, the ace point, I would like to continue the blitz. And also I would like to put my checker on the golden point, because I don't like making 22 here, but obviously the analyze shows that I'm wrong, and I'm happy that we had Jan Lazaro and Florin here, because they said in the live stream they would play the correct move, so it was better to listen to their thoughts about the position.
I concur with your thoughts here, Bojo. Yes. Yes, a nice position to highlight the importance of knowing what you're going to do based on the race and the position. Yeah, very, very informative. Okay, any final words before I close things out, Bojo?
Congratulations to Dirk Schiemann for making it to the final in the second year of the event. He's the defending champion, so let's see if he's going to be able to defend against Hideaki Ueda. We are going to inform very soon everyone when this amazing final will be played. And also congratulations to Fernando for making the run and playing very, very strong, level under 3 average, which is excellent performance. Thank you to Florin, our special guest tonight, and thank you to the stream team, Eric and Jan Lazaro. It was a pleasure being with you tonight. Thanks to all our viewers as well. And see you in the final.
All righty. And Jan Lazaro, any final words before I close out?
I completely agree with Bojo. Congratulations to Fernando for his for the very high level he showed to everyone. which makes a couple with the performance in Monte Carlo. And not a big surprise for me, because I know for me it is Fernando. It's not so surprising, but okay, played very well. And of course, big congratulations to Dirk. And I am very curious to see the final with Hideaki. I am sure it will be a wonderful final. And I don't think it's random that Dirk won last year and at least arrived in the final this year. Is really a very, very strong player.
Hear, hear. No doubt about that, Jean Lazaro. And again, congratulations to defending champion Dirk Schiemann, making it through to the final against Hideaki Ueda from Japan. Commiserations to Fernando Braconi from Italy. Great performance getting through to the semis and just pipped at the post by Dirk Schiemann. A big thank you to our honoured special guest, Florin Popa from Romania. Always a pleasure to have you in the studio, and we look forward to having you with us at some stage in the future.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Florin. And food for thought. Winston Churchill, the positive thinker, sees the invisible, feels the intangible, and achieves the impossible. That's all, folks. Be there or be square for the final. Keep an eye on Facebook and YouTube for the update for the timings here on Heroes. And we look forward to welcoming you again for the final of Best of the Best 2022. And cheers.